We have someone on the phone right now who's actually at the Broward County Elections Office, Florida Republican Congressman Matt Gaetz from outside the Broward County Supervisor of Elections Office is on the phone with us now because they've just opened the door. So we're trying to grab you and ask some questions. Are you with me?
I'm with you, Harris, from the Banana Republic of Broward County. Here we've got very passionate folks on both sides, and what concerns Republicans is not the law that would require an automatic machine recount in the governor's race or a hand recount in the Senate race. It's the fact that in Broward County, we've now had over 80,000 ballots literally spoken into existence. The law in Florida requires the supervisor of elections to report how many ballots have been cast, what voters voted at precincts or early voting, and then also to ensure that we have reconciliation as to how many ballots were returned voted and how many ballots were returned blank. Even though that's the law, it has been totally ignored by Brenda Snipes in Broward County. And so I am calling on the Florida Secretary of State, the Chief Elections Officer, to place Broward County in a state of receivership, to come in, take over, and find out what the hell is going on in Broward County where tens of thousands of ballots are mysteriously appearing.
You know, I know from what you were saying, you called it the Banana Republic of Broward County. They have had issues there before, and the election supervisor, Brenda Snipes, is expected to have a news conference inside that very office moments away. So it is great to get the congressman right now on the ground. You're in the thick of it. I would ask, and I know it's your home state, why do you call it a Banana Republic there in Broward County, and why are you there personally?
I'm here because 8 million Floridians, including my own constituents, cast ballots. And in 65 of the 67 counties in Florida, everything happened perfectly. Even in counties that were just ravaged by a Category 4 hurricane a month ago, they were able to get ballots counted by the wee hours of Wednesday morning. So my constituents are in jeopardy if we allow Banana Republic-style voting to occur in Broward County. Now, why do I call it that, Harris? Because this isn't the first time. In 2016, when Debbie Wasserman Schultz had a primary challenge, there were legal pleadings and conclusions that laid out the destruction of ballots in that Democratic primary. Was that incompetence or stupidity or corruption? Who knows? But time and again, we have elections irregularities in this one place, and it poisons the integrity of the entire Sunshine State. That's why we don't want it to happen. That's why we want state officials to come in, take charge, and have a transparent, open process where we can follow the law and have the recount without all of the shenanigans.
Congressman, I want to make sure I'm understanding you correctly. Are you saying that, because you said they kind of came out of thin air, are you saying that 80,000 votes have suddenly been found?
Harris, when we looked at the total number of votes reported by the Broward supervisor on election night as opposed to today, yes, more than 80,000.
How do you find 80,000 votes? How can you be so sure that that's what's happened?
Politico reported that in an elementary school that was a polling place, a day later, a librarian just walked out with a box of ballots and said, well, we've got to go count these. There's no chain of custody for these ballots. There are videos of ballots being moved in and out of trucks.
But it's not likely that 80,000 would have been in one box. I'm just trying to figure out, how do you find that? What is Ms. Snipes saying? How did you get to 80?
Well, I mean, it's outrageous. And the thing is, there are certain checks and balances in the process on Election Day, before Election Day, regarding reporting. And then that creates a bookend so that we're able to snag any corruption.
Right.
The problem is when the supervisor of elections ignores those requirements, then you don't have a way to reconcile how many ballots were cast, where they were cast, and then to ensure that you don't just have people filling out blank ballots that weren't voted at a polling place, stuffing them in a box, and then showing up and saying, oh, wow, we found, you know, new boxes and new truckloads and new pallets of ballots. It's outrageous, and the world is watching.
Yeah, the world is watching, and I'm so glad you're with me right now. I just want to reset the screen for a second, Congressman Gaetz, because if people are just tuning in, what they're seeing on the left side of their screen is where you are. And you're on the phone with us because they've opened the doors, and that election supervisor, Brenda Snipes, is expected to give a news conference. We're going to take our cameras on in. But on the right side of the screen are the people outside that are just a few feet away from that, yelling about the fact they're calling her sneaky Snipes. Some people are saying that they support the idea that these votes have been found. I mean, if you can read the signs, you have people from both sides. I don't even want to say political aisle, but both sides of this situation. What is the temperature of the people on the ground right now?
Well, there are our passions are running hot. You know, folks have been hollering and screaming at each other. And look, I would be frustrated, too, under a circumstance where I didn't know if my vote was counted, or more importantly, I don't know if my vote is going to be diluted by the corruption.
All right. I want to ask you about Brenda Snipes, if I can. Senator Marco Rubio has been tweeting about her quite heavily. He says, one, she illegally, and he says, look, this supervisor now has in her hands the rest outcome. Her hands may rest the outcome of Senate and cabinet race. Illegally destroyed ballots, secretly opened mail ballots, sent voters too many ballot pages, and left constitutional question off ballot. What kind of conversation do you anticipate, if at all, having with Brenda Snipes? You're there.
Well, Brenda Snipes should resign or she should be fired. We cannot reconcile.
Would you tell her that?
Negotiate with someone. Absolutely. I have called on her to be fired. If she is not fired, then frankly, you know, we will never know whether or not these are legitimate ballots. And I mean, it's really ridiculous when everyone else is able to get it right, Harris. I mean, I want to focus on that. This is not a circumstance where it's just some unique challenge. The unique challenges were elsewhere in the state, and we met them. But right here in these two blue counties, in Broward and Palm Beach, there are always these very bizarre elections outcomes. And again, even Democrats have made these allegations against Brenda Snipes because there was an allegation she was destroying ballots in a Democratic primary.
Yeah, and I'm familiar with that. I'm also familiar with what we can see on the screen, that this may not break politically. And you can see that from some of the signs. This is about just the whole kit and caboodle of whether or not the votes are real, 80,000 extra votes. Congressman, talk with me about the legality now that goes forward, because I know most members of Congress and the Senate have a legal background of some sort, and you and I have talked about these issues before.
I'm a public records lawyer. Yeah, I know this legal space relatively well. At 3 o'clock today, there will be an emergency legal proceeding regarding whether or not Brenda Snipes must turn over the record of how many ballots were cast, what were the results from each machine, and how were the ballots that were not voted reconciled? You ask, how can all these ballots disappear out of nowhere? Well, if there were blank ballots at polling stations and people got a hold of those, they could have voted them and then acted as though actual people had cast those votes on Election Day. And so we're seeking the records that will allow us to triangulate and find out whether or not there was fraud, to what extent that fraud has potentially inflated the Democratic margins in the state of Florida.
Wow, that's a lot of information, very useful. And it is, no matter how this turns out, you mentioned that Democrat primary that they had problems in Broward County, too. So at 3 p.m. Eastern today, you're going to be able to ask some of those questions and check machines. How is it that we're this far along? And I mean, we have other places where they're still counting votes, but they're not necessarily finding thousands of them.
Exactly.
So do the machines just not work well enough to say, you know, you've got overvote and undervote? Did machines count more than once for people, or did they not count? What do we know about the process?
Every machine creates a printout that indicates the results from that machine, the overvotes, the undervotes in each particular race. Those records have not been produced by Brenda Snipes, even though Floridians have a constitutional right to request them. And so, again, today we'll be asking a judge to compel Brenda Snipes to give us those machine reports so that we can figure out how many votes there are. You're right. If this was just a matter of continuing to count a known universe of votes, I think everyone could live with that. Unfortunately, you remember Rapunzel would spin straw into gold. Here we got Brenda Snipes thinning thin air into ballots, and that's really what should concern everyone.
Well, and what you talk about with your public records attorney background, which I did not even know the specificity of that, so now I even understand more why you're there. What you say at 3 p.m. today, though, is that you want to try to triangulate, just like journalists do, the facts around this. So maybe you won't have to depend so much on what you can't access, which would be those 80,000 votes and perhaps Brenda Snipes' explanation for them. You can find the facts in a triangulation with those voting machines. Before I let you go, I want you to talk with me a little bit, because I don't know if you can hear the people chanting and singing. I'm seeing some signs that say fake votes. You know, if others are watching us from around the world, we're supposed to do this better than anybody, this democratic thing we call Election Day. I just want to get your last thoughts on that. Congressman Matt Gaetz with us now from Florida.
Harris, I've traveled the world and tried to convince regimes to embrace voting and democracy and the will of the people, and we undermine our credibility in that argument when we're unable to follow the law at home. But there's still time to get this right. That's why the Secretary of State needs to step in, put this office under receivership, and let's find out what the hell is going on.
I like your positivity in terms of there's still time to get this right, because voters have to know that all votes are counted no matter what political party. Congressman
Absolutely.
Matt Gaetz, wonderful to have you on the breaking news today, our eyes and ears on the ground. I know our cameras are going to go inside for that Brenda Snipes election supervisor Broward County news conference when she holds it. Thank you, Congressman.
Thank you.